Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and if you haven't guessed it, this is a Tom Morello gear guide. Man, I haven't played that Know Your Enemy riff in so long. For such a what should be a simple riff, it's pretty hard to play. Trying to hammer on is pretty damn hard. And that is Tom Morello in a nutshell. He makes the most simple things in the world quite complex and blows minds whilst he does it. Now, many different bands over the years. His solo stuff, the Atlas Underground is his latest endeavour, and it's absolutely fantastic, collaborating with so many artists from around the world. But his guitar setup has been pretty simple. There's kind of three main guitars that you associate with him. There's the Arm the Homeless guitar, this guitar, and a Telecaster. The Arm the Homeless and the Soul Power Strat are the E guitars. This is very prominent with Audioslave. Arm the Homeless is very much Rage Against the Machine, and everything Drop D he's ever done has been on a Telecaster, because the other guitars have these wacky Floyd Rose things. So we never really played this guitar in Rage Against the Machine, but they don't make an Arm the Homeless guitar with a kill switch, so of course I'm going to use this. It's the Tom Morello signature Fender Stratocaster in all of its glory. It's kind of like an old Aerodyne, black on black, the lovely white binding, chrome pickguard. It's got a floating Floyd Rose tremolo, so you can get all your crazy, turn that harmonizer off. All that kind of cool stuff. Three-way switch for the three beautiful, no, they're not, only one of them is a Seymour Duncan. It's a hot rail in the bridge and two noiseless Fender pickups in the neck and the middle. Volume, tone, but most importantly, that all-important kill switch, which he utilizes in a lot of his playing. On the Arm the Homeless guitar, it's a toggle switch for the pickups. So there's two volumes, so he turns the neck pickup off, or the bridge pickup off, and uses it like that, like you would on a Les Paul. He has got a Les Paul as well that he loves. It's red, natural, and all knackered. It's lovely. So the Arm the Homeless, that's the pickup switch. This is a five-way switch like a regular Strat, and that's just a regular kill switch. I always forget I've turned off, and I'm like, what? Why is it not working? Ah. Lovely maple neck on this bad lad. Rosewood fingerboard, locking tuners, and matching black headstock with Tom's signature right on the end. It's just it's a glorious thing. I told you I keep doing that. Now, he rarely riffs in the bridge pickup. A lot of his stuff is in the neck pickup. Not that. So for his kind of vibe, you can't rock one of his signature guitars or just get a single coil neck pickup. Now, the Arm the Homeless guitar has quite a cool story behind it. He got that guitar made for him by a very famous LA luthier with his first paycheck when he was like a copywriter for a senator or something. And he ticked all these boxes. I want this guitar with this neck, this body, this specs to make my own hot rod custom guitar. And he absolutely hated it. He spent all his money and he hated it. So the only thing left of that original guitar is the body wood itself. It has a graphite neck with a Kramer headstock, but it's not actually a Kramer. EMG pickups, there's a H in the neck, which looks like a humbucker, but it's actually a single coil, and an EMG 85 in the bridge. And tremolo-wise, it's got an Ibanez Edge on it. He painted the hippos on it, because it's the only thing he can draw. He said, only facing the one way, and wrote Arm the Homeless on in what looks like crayon, or Sharpie, red and black Sharpie. But yeah, that has an Ibanez Edge on. And in real life, this guitar has an Ibanez Edge on as well. The real Soul Power guitar also has Soul Power written here, with a white Sharpie. This comes in the case when you buy the guitar. It's actually a sticker when you buy this guitar, so you can have a standard Morello Strat or with the Soul Power sticker on it. But yeah, this has a Floyd Rose, because Fender can't put an Ibanez bridge on the guitar, but they can put a Floyd Rose on the guitar. And they do the same thing. Now his Telecaster, which is affectionately named Sendero Luminoso. It's written here, which is Spanish for shining light, which is actually the name of the Communist Party of Peru. But anyways, his Telecaster is the Drop D guitar. Every Tom Morello song you'll hear in Drop D, like Killing in the Name Of, was recorded on the neck pickup of his Telecaster. It's totally stock. It's a 1982 Telecaster that he swapped a 50-watt Marshall for back in the day. And yeah, neck pickup of a Telecaster. It recorded one of the heaviest songs of all time, but we'll hear that shortly. So those are the guitars he's associated with. I've got a classical here because he likes to rock a classical guitar. I think he started on a classical guitar. He doesn't really play conventional acoustics. He writes everything on a classical guitar as well. We're back to the main rig of this video. I'm going through two tech cables. Firstly, into a Tom Morello wah. He has a signature GCB95 wah. It is a standard GCB95 wah, which is the like super affordable wah. He likes that because you can pick it up anywhere in the world and it'll be the same wah, and he hasn't got to bust the bank. But this has his lovely details and emblems on, fighting the power just as hard as he always has. Now, he doesn't really use wah in a conventional way. He's not there going... we'll play with wah DJ stuff in a bit. I'm going to a Boss Tuner TU2. Now, the signal chain. I'm not using a Digitech Whammy for this. That's one of his main core things. But he uses a Whammy 1, which is quite a rare, hard to find on now. It's pretty much the same as the Whammys you can get now. But I thought I'd use something different because I really enjoy using this instead of a Whammy, because Whammys are quite big and take up a lot of space on your pedal board. Electro Harmonix do the Pitchfork, which is an awesome little pitch pedal, kind of like a Pog, but you can do a bit more with it. You can add fifths, which is what the Know Your Enemy thing is. You can add octaves, but most importantly, you can go up two octaves and get the crazy. I should explain that there's an expression pedal output. So you get a stereo cable, a TRS, and I'm going to a Dunlop expression pedal on the floor and using this instead of a Whammy because I think it takes up less space on the hole. All that kind of absolutely crazy stuff, and the neighbors next door are going to absolutely hate me at the end of this video. So yeah, I thought I'd use the Pitchfork. And does a lot more, but I enjoy that for the Morello stuff. Pretty simple pedal board. He's had the same pedal board for years. He has an EQ pedal, which he only uses to boost for solos. So I haven't got it here because there's pointless boosting for solos. It's basically just everything flat, but up slightly. Phase 90, which he only uses for the entire set for the intro to Killing the Name Of, which you'll hear shortly when I use the Telecaster. Tremolo, which he only uses. Those are the right settings as well. So everything at 3 o'clock. He uses four. Like a stone. Great sound, great pedal, and iconic for that iconic song. Rest in peace, Chris Cornell. Delay. He's got two delays on his board, one long, one short, so you can like have different delay sounds during the set. I've just got one here because I can use my hands and change it because I'm not playing in front of thousands and thousands of people. These settings are the settings he uses for a really quick, intense delay when he plays with the kill switch, so check that out. He uses DD3s. This is the new DD8 because this wasn't around when he built that board. So that's the delay sound. One delay, quite loud. That's that delay. The other sound is essentially everything all the way up for a classic solo sound. Yeah. yeah, that is the fun delay pedal. This over on the left is the new MXR Power 50 Tom Morello signature sound in a box, but you'll hear that right at the end. For now though, I want to use this actual rig. So it's a Marshall JCM800. He uses a 2205, which is a slightly later 80s two-channel variant with built-in reverb. He doesn't use any of the reverb, that's just the model he got. The age-old story is his gear was stolen. That's the only amp they had in the store. He wasn't massively keen on it, so after years of having the arm, the homeless guitar, which he couldn't really get a decent sound out of because he hated it, and then the amp, he was like, no, I'm just gonna make music with what I've got, and he's been doing it ever since. He set the controls where he liked them right there, wrote on what the dials were set to, and left it there in the late 80s, and they're still there to this day. And the settings are, the gain, either a quarter of the way up or all the way up, depending on the venue and what mood he's feeling. The bass in the middle, all the way up as well, because why the devil not? The treble, about 2 o'clock, so like 7 or 8, and the presence at 10 o'clock. And yeah, this is just the amp by itself. Cab-wise, back in the day and still now, he uses a PV cab. Not sure what's in it, but he bought the Marshall head and a PV cab. He does switch between a Marshall cab and the PV cab, but the PV cab is his tone. So, I'm hearing it through this Marshall cab, but I have an impulse response of a PV cab in the two notes Torpedo Captor X, which this Marshall is going into, emulating that cab out of an XLR into a Zoom thing and then into your ears. So you're hearing more of an authentic Morello sound than what I am in this room. How spooky is that? It's really cool playing heavy riffs on the neck pickup. It's just instant rage against the machine, no matter what kind of stuff you play. Right, let's plug the telly in and get all dropped. So neck pickup, black Telecaster. The only time in this set just over 9 o'clock on a phase 90. It's all about really how you attack the guitar to get that Morello kind of. He often goes to the bridge pickup on the homeless, on the soul power and the telly when it comes to doing lead lines and stuff, so. That's just so intense, it's excellent. So yeah, that's the telly and where he uses a phaser. Now back when Rage first started out, they wanted a DJ in the band because they all loved rap and hip hop. But there was no DJ available back then. So Tom took it on himself to be the resident DJ in the band. Now I suck at this, but I'm gonna show you how to do it anyways. So Tom does DJ stuff on his guitar. He always has and it's absolutely crackers. Basically just like, that sounds a bit like when DJs scratch the decks, whatever it's called. I sound like an old person, but yeah. Mix it with a kill switch. I suck at that. But when you put a wah in, it sounds a bit more DJ-ish. I suck at this so hard. But you get the gist, when you add a slide, it sounds even cooler. I'm sorry, Tom Morello, if you watch this. But yeah, this is his gear. I'm not Tom Morello, I said that at the start. What else he does, which is crackers, He takes his jack out and gives it a bit of a press. Yeah, he does that. So that is a rundown of his guitars, his pedals, his amplifiers, and the way he implements them into sounding like one of the most awesome guitar players on the planet. Now let's plug in the Power 50 to an amp that isn't this Marshall. Let's plug it into a Fender, it doesn't sound anything like a Marshall, to see if we can get that Tom Morello tone. It's pretty much there, like. It's just a classic kind of Marshall in a box pedal. MXR are great at doing that. Super easy to use as well. 3-band EQ, bass, middle, treble, 1 volume control, 1 gain control, and a presence control to control the upper mid-range. I like it about halfway up. What's cool as well is there's an effects loop. So you can run this with delays within the, like delays and reverbs and everything you'd put in the amp's effects loop. Run this as an amplifier and have like it all built into one, like a little tiny amp on your pedal board, a little JSA-800 on your pedal board. It's absolutely awesome. Bravo MXR and Tom Morello. Now there's a full review of this mighty little MXR Tom Morello Power 50 here on the PMTVUK YouTube channel. I'll link it in the description box down below. Go a bit more in depth, get some more gainier tones, get some cleaner tones. It's a fantastic little box that does a lot more than just Tom Morello stuff, but it's a must have for any Rage Against the Machine fan, Nightwatchmen fan, any Tom Morello fan. It's a great little collaboration between MXR and Mr. Morello. I think, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. A swift little gear guide, all the guitars Tom uses, the amplifiers, the pedals, and the way in which he implements them to get his iconic, awesome tone. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. If I missed anything, feel free to add anything or expand on anything that I've been chatting about. It's been a bit of fun, and everything is available from PMT. Again, I'll link everything in the description box down below. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. Again, for all the info, description box, or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of all these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.